Jeff, what are you hearing on Andrew Luck?
Well, Greeny, anytime you hear at the end of an injury when it's referred to as the ankle-ish area, that's usually a little bit disconcerting. Like, they can't even narrow down exactly what it is that is wrong with Andrew Luck. And if you're a Colts fan or a sports fan, you're thinking back to 2017 when we felt like we were going through this same thing with Andrew Luck's shoulder. It does feel a little bit reminiscent of that, not only from the transparency standpoint of what's exactly going on with Luck, but probably more importantly, the fact that the team really can't figure it out at this point. So when we are talking about 3.5 weeks, that is disconcerting. Chris Ballard, though, making a very valid point. When he got there, he wanted to construct a roster that was not centered around just one player, important as Andrew Luck is, so that they could win games with Jacoby Brissett before they get him back. So at least, even if it takes a couple weeks before he does get back, they feel like they can still put together at least a roster capable of winning.
Now, that's reasonable, depending, I guess, on what they mean by a few weeks, but maybe that's sort of like an ankle-ish area kind of a thing. Stay with me, Jeff. We're going to come back to you in a minute for much more, but I want to take this one to the table for the first time because and we've been hearing about a calf, and now all of a sudden it sounds like that was a geographical reference as opposed to a physiological reference. It's in the neighborhood of his calf. What does all this tell you?
So first of all, like, I think the transparency issue at the beginning, if this was the case, okay, that might be plausible, but one of the other things that people don't talk about is the compensation of the human body. So if you have something wrong with your calf and you're trying to work through that, now this is kind of migrating down your leg, there's going to be issues with this. And the real thing with the Colts is, you know, they may have built this roster and Chris Ballard's done a great job with it, but with Jacoby Brissett, there may be an 8-18 top. So with Andrew Luck, this is a Super Bowl caliber roster, so they need to have him out there.
What'd you make of this, Victor?
Yeah, I agree with Bobby. I think looking at this team, I had them picked to be a huge Super Bowl contending football team, especially with the year that Andrew Luck had last year, doing all those great things, and then coupling that with Paris Campbell, adding some more weapons into the fold here offensively. I had them picked to go into a deep run, potentially a Super Bowl type run. And now with this calf injury also lingering down to what they're describing as an ankle-ish high ankle injury now, it worries me. It puts this team in jeopardy of their future, at least for this year, because Andrew Luck is the engine that drives this train. And without Andrew Luck out there, like you said, with Jacoby Brissett, they're an average team at best with him at the helm. They got to figure out how to get Andrew Luck out there. I've had a calf injury. Those things linger. You want to be able to go out there when you're 100% and when you feel 100%. And even when you feel 100%, take another week so that you are sure that you can go out there and play.
Well, what, if anything, do you read from all of the uncertainty? I mean, Jeff makes it sound, and it's certainly the way it comes out, makes it sound like even they aren't really exactly sure what this is, or they're not sure how to deliver the information to the rest of us. What does that say to you?
Yeah, it sounds like they can't put their finger quite on what this is. And I think when they're talking to Andrew Luck and they're asking him, how do you feel? I think he's probably giving them an array of answers of how he feels and different things that are going on with his leg that lead them to think, okay, how do we attack this? Do we treat it like a calf injury? Do we treat it like an ankle injury? I think they're in flux on how to deal with this specific injury.
And the main thing I hear about that is if you're not gonna be able to accurately diagnose it publicly, either you don't really know what it is, or it's something that's more severe and you're trying to downplay it. So that, exactly, to me, is what that's saying, is they're not ready exactly to put a label on it because they don't know. Or if we hear about it, you might think this is not a 3.5 week deal. We should be more concerned than we are right now.
Yeah, exactly. And to the point of Jacoby Brissett, he is a good, able backup quarterback. If they need him to play for 2 or 3 weeks, I think we all believe that they can withstand that. If this is a situation where we're going to miss Andrew Luck or he is significantly less than himself for the majority of a season, then this takes this from a Super Bowl team to a team that won't even make the playoffs. I think we all agree on that general thought.
They're not winning the South without Andrew Luck.
He's that important of a player in what is suddenly a very competitive division.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports, highlights, and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.